I came to the cryptocurrency space. And to date, I've not had the time to regret the last money I removed from my account. It was the extra one I raised from a friend to invest in cryptocurrency. Let's do justice to risk management and the future of cryptocurrency. First of all, I want you to understand the blockchain and security. Security, if you are a programmer or you work as a nerd, you will understand that security is one of the main issues or one of the most important factors when it comes to computer science or information technology. One of the reasons Bitcoin has thrived as the most robust and the most relevant blockchain or the most resilient technology so far on Earth is because of the level of security we have in the open blockchain. Bitcoin for 9 years, this is the first thing I want to let you know. I want to give you an assurance about the open blockchain called Bitcoin. Bitcoin has existed for 9 years plus. It has not been hacked. It's over a $200 billion money network, and it's the most attacked technology on Earth. It's the one where hackers have spent millions of dollars trying to break it down, and they've not succeeded. Bitcoin has gotten to a stage where it is now, what would I call it now? Something you can't hack again, anti-hack. Now, it's now like you, the more you're trying to hack it, the more it's developing resilience. Someone last week shared a video of the scam going on Bitcoin network. And you can see different attacks, red, trying to stop transactions from moving. And for 9 good years, Bitcoin has not had a downtime. We've never had a time where we'll say, I want to send money now, and there's no network about Bitcoin. It has happened to your banks. It has happened to even WhatsApp. It has happened on Facebook. It has happened even to the biggest bank on planet Earth. It has never happened to Bitcoin. I think that's the first big plus why people are ready to sink in millions of dollars into this network. Okay, next. One of the things you will also need to be careful with is, so I've given you first assurance about Bitcoin as the open blockchain, its security. Now, that responsibility about it being secure, just like the internet, is already safe. Now let's go to the one that is your own responsibility, which is first, your password and your private keys. Please, when you come into this space as a novice or you're new into it, I want to give you this advice. And even if you're old in it, let me remind you again. Do not share something they call your wallet, private keys and password to anyone or even any website. If you go to any website and they say, please put in your wallet private keys here, we want to send you social amount of money, so the money will send you bigger than the one you have in your wallet. Exit. Run for your life. Okay, next. We have what we call hardware wallets that you can get for yourself. You can use a Ledger Nano, you can use a Trezor, you can use KeepKey. KeepKey is owned by Eric Voss company, ShapeShift. These are all hardware wallets. They look like this. And then you can store your Bitcoin, have your private keys, everything there, store even Ethereum, some other altcoin, ARK, in some of these hardware wallets, and travel with them to anywhere in the world, and they are safe. One of the beauty of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency technology is the fact that money has been separated from states where I can be in Venezuela, and then if I want to exit this country because of what the government is doing, and I have $1 million, I don't need to go through a bank again. I just carry my private key, my hardware wallet, or even my password and this thing, and I exit. And I go start a new life in another country like Nigeria. Okay. Now, these are pictures of Trezor. This is KeepKey. This is Ledger Nano. You cannot connect them to even your phone, your computer, your laptop, and access your Bitcoin wallet. Very secure. Even if it gets destroyed, there's a kind of arrangement you can still make with the company and it's still safe. Your Bitcoin is safe. Not this. Somebody asking your private keys. Now, somebody would say, if I have a wallet and the wallet shuts down tomorrow, if blockchain.info shuts down tomorrow, even though it's not possible, will I still be able to access my Bitcoin as long as you have your private keys? Satoshi Nakamoto has 1 million Bitcoin, and as at then, there was no company that was saying we are wallet providers. Wallet providers are just people who are like interface to the blockchain. Your Bitcoin is still on the blockchain. No wallet holds your Bitcoin for you. They are all interface or intermediaries between you and the blockchain. So as long as Satoshi Alfini gave his private keys to wife has private keys, kids have his private keys. So same with Satoshi. Satoshi has his own private keys. So if he's alive or dead, whoever has the private keys can have access to that 1 million Bitcoin without even going through Ledger Nano, Coinbase, or any of them. Google Authenticator 2FA, very, very important. If you're trading on any exchange, you have a wallet, you're trading on any exchange, please take this measure. It will be easier for a hacker to go into your account and siphon funds if you don't have this. They can break your password, but once you have a 2FA that you control with your phone, it's easier for you to secure. I've never had any issue with hack since I came into this space. I've never had any issue with somebody saying they stole money from my wallet and transferred to another wallet, because I've taken proper security measures for myself. Now, some people give options for SMS authenticator, but I avoid it. Because MTN, the data for MTN can be manipulated. The data for Airtel and all these companies, they are not secure. So if you do SMS authenticator, it could there could be a breach on the way and somebody gets access to your account. So the best thing, I avoid SMS authenticator, because you could easily be hacked through your network service provider. Next one, avoid public Wi-Fi. Some of you will be trading and you go to ShopRite, and because you see a public Wi-Fi in ShopRite, you say, okay, let me use it. The moment you do that, a hacker has access to your laptop, especially if you use Windows. And it's because of things like this I personally have to use a MacBook, but yet I don't use any public Wi-Fi. Because once you do, if somebody who is very knowledgeable with security matters, it could disrupt and see every activity you are doing on your laptop or your system. And guess what? He has access to your phones, he has access to your trading account, and you'll just be surprised. Have you ever seen, is there anybody here who you were trying to browse around 3 a.m., 2 a.m., probably with a public Wi-Fi or even your own Wi-Fi, and one day your blockchain.info wallet, if someone just move like that? If you've ever experienced that, it's issues like this. Avoid emails, avoid malicious websites. Now, I'm going to focus on this now. Somebody had this experience with somebody, a senator's son, who sold Bitcoin to. So I told him, you came into this space, fine. He finally believed in Bitcoin, bought $8,000 worth of Bitcoin. Good, we're impressed. So this guy's ready to Bitcoin. Next week, the next news I had, Chris, I have a problem. What's the problem? There was this site I saw on Google. So okay, I sent the $8,000 to them, and they said they will mine for me. Really told me the thing. I just found the full money, and they're like $8,000. I first had to do the calculation. Then Bitcoin was just $7,000. And I did the calculation. He said they promised him to turn on investment. That's the thing that the lecturer before now taught. They promised him to turn on investment. So the person said, send me the site. So when I did the site, I had to check the expiry date for the site. The site will expire December 2017. They did all kind of malicious things. They even linked their website to rojavasbitcoin.com mining pool. So with that, you could feel their right. And they will show you, we've received $8,000, $7,000. And the guy wrote emails upon emails upon emails. And even the one they promised to pay him is still hanging. So that's how the $8,000 won. Now, when you go on Google and you see anything about adverts about cryptocurrency, avoid it. Google doesn't even have full information about cryptocurrency. That's why if you're into the cryptocurrency space, belong to a cryptocurrency community. It will aid your growth. Okay, next. Avoid emails asking you for your password and private keys. Always cross-check the name of the website for your exchange and wallet to avoid the phishing site. I have a friend of mine, he's a popular guy on Facebook, Bella. The guy's an expert. It can happen to anybody. Bella has been in the cryptocurrency space for 3 years. Bella went to mistakenly press BITTT, Bittrex, the phishing site, and sent his funds to that exchange and thought, and that's how this guy lost over 20 Bitcoin. Gone like that. So he had to, it was a devastating moment for him. I mean, he's an expert, he's a good trader. So check it. If it is Binance.com, let it be BINANCE. They have websites that are Binance with double E.com. They will look like the exchange. They will, everything will be the same. Immediately you give them your information, for instance, your email, they have every other details. Now, because this is a billion, this industry is going to be a $1 trillion network. So hackers are already ahead. So you should be conscious with security. In short, in Switzerland now, they have companies that store private keys for people. That is, what we do is giving insurance companies our data. Now, you could just go to this and they have a safe where you store maybe your ledger nano, your private keys, and probably when you have exited or you are dead, they will transfer the same thing to your kids. Now, for those who want to also see how they can transfer their wealth to their children and they don't have their emails and password, now, there's a kind of form you can fill online. I don't have those data offhand here now. There's a kind of data you can fill online, both with your wallet providers, with your email, that if they don't see you talk to them for 4 months, they'll communicate with your next of kin. Measures like that are already in place. So when somebody say, if I lose my Bitcoin, my child cannot see, you're only talking because you're ignorant. The space is growing, and there are service providers for different parastatals emerging. Okay, I've talked about avoiding public Wi-Fi usage. Lost. Security. So next, let's go to the future of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. And when I was giving this topic, I told myself, we're going to talk about the future, we're still in the present. Nobody knows about what's going to happen, but with the past, we can predict the future. And with the current trend, we can say this is what will happen. First of all, when you come to people, I've been worried about Bitcoin. Now, some of you during December period, early this year, you had issues with transaction fees high. You showed your mom to say, Bitcoin, this is nonsense. Fees are high. But let me tell you something. If you're going to see something, freedom doesn't come without a cost. Do you know how many banks want Bitcoin dead? Do you know how many governments want Bitcoin dead? Do you know, I was in Aja when they called off the CMB2X hard fork. I asked my friend, I was on the floor, I just was a sense of breath. There's a big conspiracy against this industry. Macron, the president of France, spoke against Bitcoin in the World Forum. Mère Teresa, whatever her name is, spoke against Bitcoin. We should be careful. Your CBN governor that has not even killed inflation in his nation said cryptocurrency is a gamble. The Naira is the worst gamble we have. And they warn you about this. And there are government systems during this CBN2X problem. What do the banks want? The big corporation were sponsoring a code called BTC1. What was BTC1 going to do? They will make sure this the new code Bitcoin runs on, that everybody who signs into the Bitcoin network submits his name and number. So the government already has access. And let me tell you something. The founders of the people who took on cryptocurrency projects were new net. They were not interested in how rich they would be. They were interested in privacy, security, separation of money and state. And they were ready to do anything that would not make the government have access to their property and the community. And that was the period that knew Bitcoin would survive the next 10 years, 20 years. To hell with whatever anybody's going to say. Bitcoin has come to stay. So within those periods, Segwit was finally activated. The big boys said they wouldn't activate it because they were making some money from some dubious things they were doing with the blockchain, but you can't do that for long. So the likes of Roger Ver and his team were busy spamming the network. They will send transactions because they are miners. They will send fast transactions. Before your transaction comes, your transaction will be at the back. Before you see confirmation, you see weeks, weeks upon weeks. You talked about ASIS boost. One of the things Segwit does is that Segwit detects ASIS. And ASIS is easy to manipulate during mining. And the guys behind who Satoshi left Bitcoin for to develop don't like the ASIS technology. Because it makes you mine empty block and you get money for it. Just like a bricklayer coming. And until ASIC is working with everybody, it has not worked, but it's getting paid. That's what Bitmain is doing. That's what the largest miner in China is doing. So we run these things. They discover that miners are having monopoly over the Bitcoin network. Guess what? Alfini, I read the Bitcoin talk where Alfini was interacting with Satoshi, and they were all interacting, and they said, Bitcoin on the chain transaction may not scale. It is hard to scale blockchains. Just like the internet. The internet has been scaling for 25 years. Just like the internet. This is the way the Bitcoin is. What TCIP is to the internet is what Bitcoin is to the blockchain technology and the cryptocurrency space. So it is hard to scale these things. And the next big thing is, if there are all transactions that are batched like this, there can be a second layer. That is, if Ambode creates a road going to Aja and blocks and cars are filled up here, they can create another road, maybe underground space, where a train can go through, and those of you who don't want to wait in this batch can go through this railway and get to your destination. That solution was called second layer. Some group of guys saw this, just a talk Satoshi and Alvin did. They picked up something from it. And today, they took on a project for the past 3 years called Lightning Network. Lightning Network is going to send some altcoins back to their village. Lightning Network will send some bank back to their village. The things you all complain about, see, it is already in Bitcoin. It's just with time. Developers, because of security, they don't rush things. They take their step to build. So Lightning Network is already on the mainnet testing. So it's even faster than the way we expect. So what are the developments or the future for Bitcoin? You will see things like Lightning Network, instant payment, transactions will be very cheap. But as time goes on, because of security, you may not see too much cheap transactions. Somebody asked me, between speed and security, which one do you want? I said, I want security. If we pay for security to have our money, our privacy, let's pay for it. We'll have more privacy. We'll have continuous development and security updates, sure signature. Bitcoin is not sleeping. Developers are not sleeping. Every day they are trying to make sure that thing that happened to Charlie Shem, where somebody did something through his exchange and they were able to trace the IP. In future, you will not be able to even do any trace to the Bitcoin transactions. Just like you have it on Zcash. Bitcoin, there will be, now, currently, every day they keep having updates on cryptocurrencies. What is the future of cryptocurrency? There will not be thousands of coins. There will be hundreds of thousands of altcoins and cryptocurrencies. I mean, there will be you see them in their numbers. This disruption has come. You can't stop it. The mistake you made was not stopping Satoshi that day. Because you couldn't stop Satoshi from releasing that white paper, you can't stop the revolution now. And the revolution is now bigger than Satoshi Nakamoto himself. Every sector of the economy will be tokenized. See, you will come to this hotel and you will see a coin called 4 points coin. trip on our 4-point coin will have a 20% discount for renting our halls. Every owner of 4-point coins, when they lodge in our hotel for 1 week, they will get 3 days extra. Economy is being tokenized. You will see Covenant University have a coin related to their university, and every student who has that coin gets 3% discount, more services. The economy is about to be tokenized. Programmable money has given everyone a platform to be a central bank of his own. So your central bank, the influence of central bank will be reduced. Now, what about the cryptocurrency economy? There will be so many thriving centralized projects. We can't do without centralized projects. We need them. But the big vision is decentralization, which will help each and every one of us become centralized, doing our own thing ourselves. Indeed, money and state will be separated. That is, look at it now. Some of us are not moved with the Nigerian economy. If you were in Bitcoin when I came into Bitcoin at $500 US, and you do what I'm doing, I don't think Nigerian economy should affect you. I don't even know the last time I started bothering about whether fuel is 250. Why? Bitcoin, the world from Bitcoin makes you live above any economy. What's the future of mining? We've had a problem in the Bitcoin network. One guy called Jihan. The guy can decide to switch his mining equipment to Bcash. And you hold all your Bitcoin network hosting for 2 days. You see transactions, hundreds of thousands of transactions not confirmed. The mistake Slushpool did was Slushpool was being sacrificial in the early days. You'd have been among the big boys in the mining space. He's also a big boy, but he doesn't have enough hashing power. Like Bitmain. So Bitmain had the backing of the Chinese government. That's why. You can't see such a big mining farm in China without government backing. But the next thing, China wants to have control. You know the problem we have in Bitcoin? One of the problems? China as a country doesn't believe in open source projects. They made a mistake when they entered Bitcoin and they thought they could control Bitcoin so that they could become world economic power. But they couldn't. So what are we going to see in the mining space? Where she lives in Canada. Canada is providing clean energy for miners. Miners are now switching. Even Oga himself, Bitmain, is now switching to another country called Switzerland. So the same way our politicians carry all their money to Swiss Bank, Switzerland. Switzerland will also be one of the home for Bitcoin mining. Hence, making it a wealthy nation. While your country will be here, they won't give you light. They will still complain that cryptocurrency is a gamble. It's a scam. Run from it. You didn't warn me about the stock market when it crashed. You didn't warn me when First Bank was thriving, going up. You didn't tell me to crash. You didn't tell me as a student when I bought my first shares that today that shares is not even worth $1,000. You didn't tell me all these things. And now I'm in Bitcoin cryptocurrency. My life has changed and you said I should go away from it. To hell with your policy. Let me live my life. Countries like Japan, Bitcoin contributed 0.6% to the GDP of Japan last year. Japan itself legalized Bitcoin. Immediately legalized it, you see what happened? Exchanges started opening, industries started opening, employment came up. You see a young guy in his house, one room, this laptop, GPS, some of the coins some of you are buying. If I tell you the kind of room the guys do it, you will not want to buy. But why? The government has created a thriving environment for this. Why can't you do that in Africa? That's why I don't believe in governance system yet. It's not helping matters. So Japan is already ready. So countries like Japan, Canada, Switzerland, and even China, China don't have to take back seats. They know. Because if you can't beat them, you join them. So since China has been part of it from day one, they will continue being part of it. But now that 70% of Bitcoin mining is in China, you see it reduced to either 50. It's going to be a small, small stuff. Because even the guys themselves don't like the kind of system they bring. There will be swift regulations on exchanges like we see in South Korea recently. I like what South Korea did. There are exchanges they find this week, $10,000, $100,000. Why? South Korean government itself tried hacking the exchange and it was easy. They saw the data of customers, they find them. That's a good government. If that's the kind of regulation we have in the cryptocurrency space, I am backing it 100%. Because with that, you will have less funds stolen. A particular project this week, NEM, was stolen hundreds of millions, 400 millions. If it was the early days of cryptocurrency, the market would crash. But when that kind of news came, people don't care again. The market is resilient. The market is getting mature. We're in the market cycle of maturity stage. So you can't stop this now. Now, ICOs will replace venture capital. Everything I'm telling you here, mark these things down. This is the future. There was a time in America today, if you want to invest in a company, you must be an angel investor. For you to be an angel investor, you need certification. You need to have some number of income. You need to have this. That's why some of them in the US couldn't invest their money into Uber, into projects like Facebook, Google, early because they're not certified investors. Why are you limiting us from putting our money? But if you want to gamble, you don't need certification. So you can go to Texas and spend all your money there and become broke in 24 hours, in 1 hour, in one night. But invest in a startup to put your $10 in Facebook that multiplies to $1,000 in the future. They don't allow it. You have to be a certified investor. The government, with centralized policy, has limited growth and privacy and freedom. True liberty is liberty away from government. So venture capitals are now the ones who now own Facebook. But today, since crypto came, Facebook is scared. Wall Street is scared. How? FICO will wake up. But do you not see you? In 10 minutes, these guys have raised $1 billion. Where in the world is this happening? Wall Street is like, what? Goldman Sachs took how many years to hit $250 billion? I don't use the current market cap for Bitcoin. Because do you know that when Bitcoin hit $200 million, profit was taken? Did you calculate profit I was taking? Did you calculate when we hit 300 million, 300 million was removed, 300 million was removed from the market? When all this was happening, that's why you watch. Stock markets, they do quarterly reports. Who gives quarterly report for cryptocurrency? Nobody. A company came this week and said they are doing rating for crypto. They gave Bitcoin C, they gave Cardano B, they gave Ethereum C or so. The founder of Cardano came on Twitter and said that's a rubbish report. Any report that doesn't give Bitcoin A for 9 years of consistent innovation, 9 years, not but $34 billion was zoomed away from stock market in South Africa. They didn't tell you guys. If that thing happened in Bitcoin, CNN, Bitcoin just crashed. 100 billion just zoomed away from the Bitcoin network and nobody can find it. Oh, Warren Buffett said it. Oh, this guy said it. The government have always been right. But then, if nobody could hack it away. The blockchain is so open. One day I was on Twitter and I saw a transaction, a Bitcoin transaction. And I clicked on that blockchain ID and I saw $200 million being zoomed from one person to another, either an exchange or a company, without a bank. Bitcoin has made it easy. So ICOs will replace venture capitals. It will not be easy for a boy called Temidayo to be in his room and he has a project and he can use Facebook to collect money for charging advance. But the guy can be on Steemit and he has a community on Steemit and he will write a project on Steemit and Isabella will see it, Chris Ali will see it, somebody will see it. They will upvote him. He will have Steam dollars. He will have up to $100, $200 a week, $300 a week. What he would have gotten on Facebook, but Facebook will only be likes, no money. He will be the one funding Facebook, but this time around he's the one promoting innovation on Steam. And somebody on Steam will say, that's a good upvote. $5. That's a good upvote. $3. And before you know, the boy can crowdfund a project right in this room in Ondo State or Ibadan. without any government restriction, without even paying tax, and he's been able to raise $1,000 for his project, life becomes good. Dreams become achieved. Things are not happening. We don't need any government to make this happen. This is where the future we're talking about. It's beyond just buying and selling. It's beyond asking, if I put 1 million in Bitcoin, how much will I get? People who ask those questions irritate me. Because you don't know that what you're entering is a new adventure. It's a new system. So get ready for new regulations. It's no longer going to be, I thought a stockbroker trading. He said for 20 years, Chris. For 20 good years. He's a big boy in this industry. When I mean one of the big guys in First Bank. For 20 years I've been in this industry, I've never seen something like this. You challenge my brain. Cryptocurrency will make you, if you're a big boy, when you come into cryptocurrency with all the knowledge you have in stock, learn. You see a 17-year-old guy teaching you what you don't know. Just learn. If he says TA is TA, just say yes. If he says fundamental analysis, just say yes. If he says open a Twitter account, just say yes. Don't argue. Because the moment you add this, I know it before, you just see red color. Cryptocurrency companies will acquire some banks and traditional finance companies. I have the founder of Crypto Wallet. Let's give him a round of applause. One of the founders of the first indigenous, one of the major indigenous wallet providers in Nigeria. They have a wallet company, Crypto, here in Nigeria. One of the companies they are affiliated with just bought a full retirement company, a company that services all these tax, retirement, auditing. So one day, the streets of First Bank, where you see UBA, will now become Bitcoin exchange centers. They'll become cryptocurrency exchange centers. An exchange will be going on, over-the-counter trading will be going on in volumes, in millions. Guess what? Your child, my own unborn child, will not need to go to the bank to queue, because if he wants to go to Covenant University, all I need to do is buy Covenant University tokens on the coin market. And I send to the wallet address of the company, they confirm my transaction and send me a report, and my child already has admission into Covenant University, and I pay for his bills. And if he wants to do something with Covenant University restaurant, he can go there with those tokens and just, this is what he will just do. They have I have a friend of mine who is the ambassador for Dash. What they do is this. If you're doing a Dash project, just tell them your public address. And then they just scan the thing. Payment is done. I will no longer need to go to First Bank and queue. I will no longer need to go to the bank and say, I have 1 million. And the guy who has 3,000 naira, they will bypass him and say, you wait. You have 2 million. Come and see the manager. Such things we don't do like that in the cryptocurrency space. Equity will be promoted. Fairness will be promoted. This week, BitGo bought a finance company that has 100,000 customers. Because they will give power to the new power. Rulers will now subdue to the next new rules run by protocols. Open source projects like this. Some of our kids may not even need to have a bank account. Because if you're making transactions for them in Bitcoin,